This is the GAC Weekly presented by the Great American Conference. I'm Joey McWilliams. Glad to be with you on this afternoon. It's a beautiful day where I am right now. It's getting hot. That means summertime is here. There's not that much left to talk about in the 2017-2018 athletic year, but we'll find a few things. As a matter of fact, there are still some high points that we can visit about, and I get a chance to visit with someone today with whom I get to work on a regular basis. Michael Westbrook is the voice of the GAC Sports Network and a personal friend of mine. Michael, glad to have you on the GAC Weekly today.
Hey, Joey. Thanks so much for having me. And I was just listening to a weather report say that the typical temperature this time of year is actually high 80s, low 90s, believe it or not. But, yeah, we're going to be at about 105 or something by the end of the week. So you're right, it is hot out there.
That is it. And from where I am in southeastern Oklahoma, I mean, we missed three-digit temperatures for the majority of the summer last year, so that we're already there right now, and it's just the end of May. I don't know. I think I can do without that. All right, let's talk a little sports, though, because that'll help us cool down at least a little bit. If I start sweating right now, you'll know. It's just I was just thinking about the temperature just a little bit too much. There have been a lot of good things going on within the Great American Conference. Specifically, we've been talking about Southern Arkansas, and that Magnolia has been the center of the GAC universe. It's actually been the center of the Central Region for the last couple of weeks. And, well, the Lady Mule Riders, the softball team, the run finally came to an end. And it came to an end in the national semifinals as Southern Arkansas comes in with a third-place finish in the softball, a record of 60-11. That's right, I said 60-11. Michael, what a fantastic year for this team.
Well, there's no doubt. It's the conference's first 60-win season team. We've talked a lot about the history of Great American Conference softball and the way it has improved. I went back and looked through some of the standings over the last few years. You know, we had a couple of 40-win seasons by a couple of schools in the early days, and then the plateau was kind of set around 45, and then last year Harding has 50-plus wins, and SAU's had a 50-plus win season before going to the College World Series a couple of years ago. Well, I guess the mark is 60 now, and then beyond that, we'll look for, 60-plus wins and a national championship, because in softball, we've certainly had some teams that are close to that, and SAU has now kind of set the mark as far as where the standard is going to the Division II World Series in two of the last three seasons.
Yeah, and when there is really, I guess, only one more step. I mean, a national runner-up finish, of course, would be one step higher.
Yeah.
But the national championship and 60-plus wins and what Coach Anderson has done there with the program. Of course, we have to talk about some players, and you can't talk about Southern Arkansas softball of late without talking about Brooke Goad.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, and you know, one of the things.
Oh, yeah, she played.
Yeah, and what a career. What a stellar career, and just amazing numbers. Not only what she did hitting home runs and setting records there, but the fact that most teams didn't even want to pitch to her this year. I mean, she led the nation in walks by a significant number, 91 walks in only 71 games. Just to put that in perspective, the second most walks by any individual player was a player from Chico State with 53. Now, there were a few others that had a per-game average a little bit higher, but 53, 47, 45, as you go down the list, are the next closest competitors. When it comes to most walks in a year, 91, I mean, that is just incredible. And then, you know, they were led in the pitching circle this year by Victoria Taylor, who had just the one loss, 33 wins. She's just a sophomore. So while they're losing Brooke Goad, I mean, you've got a lot of confidence if you're Coach Anderson and his staff and the entire SAU community, knowing that, you've got your lead pitcher coming back for another couple of years.
On the phone right now with Michael Westbrook. And Michael, I had the opportunity to visit last week with Doug Self, the Southwestern Sports Information Director, and he was mentioning that baseball is one of those sports that the GAC really can kind of hang its hat on. I think the same could be said about softball.
Well, I do too, because, you know, while our teams, Harding, Arkansas Tech, Southern Arkansas, have dominated the region the last several years, it goes beyond that in the sense that when you look at some of the great teams in the state of Texas. I know that's not in our region, but Angelo State, West Texas A&M. You look at some of the other schools in Oklahoma that are in our region, University of Central Oklahoma. You know, they have really dominated this area, not only in the actual NCAA region, but then spread that out a little bit further to some of those other, I guess you just call them areas, even though they really, to me, are in our region when it really comes down to it. So, yeah, I think you've got to say that Great American Conference softball is a team, as a unit, is somebody to be reckoned with throughout.
We move along to golf, and the Great American Conference had 9 teams, women's and men's golf teams, that moved on and competed at the NCAA championship level, at least by way of the regional tournament. The Arkansas Tech men's golf team made it through to the national quarterfinals. They lost to Lynn in the quarterfinals, but a fantastic season for the Wonder Boys yet again.
Yeah, no doubt. I read about a week ago a factoid, a GAC toid that was tweeted out by that research department that we have that is so great, that Arkansas Tech, Southeastern men's golf are just 2 of 13 programs in the nation that have made multiple national championship appearances in the last 3 years. So I know it's kind of been the storyline over the first 4 or 5 years that maybe people don't know about these GAC teams or they don't know about this league, but all the way across the board, they know about the Great American Conference now. And if you're a sports information director or an athletic director or somebody associated with these programs and your season doesn't come to an end till late May, that's a really great thing. I know it might shorten your summer up a little bit, but it's well worth it for those programs.
Of course, Southeastern, you mentioned Southeastern finished 10th in the national championships as well. So congratulations to the Wonder Boys and to the Savage Storm for stellar seasons. And we move along to track, and that is – an area that we haven't talked about that much. This is year 7 of the Great American Conference. We may not have talked about it that much. There's a reason to talk about it right now, and that is because the GAC has its first national champion, and that is Landon Huslig, who won the 400-meter hurdle championships in Division II in Charlotte, North Carolina. And, of course, Landon, a member of the Oklahoma Christian team. Now, if you're not familiar with Oklahoma Christian, it is an affiliate member of the Great American Conference when it comes to outdoor track. And so that's a fantastic thing, not only for the Eagles, it's the first Division II national championship for the Oklahoma Christian Eagles, as well as for the GAC.
Yeah, absolutely. School record, 49.67. I'm sure you had a chance to watch the video, but if people haven't seen it, if you go to the Great American Conference website, click on men's track and field, you can find the video there. And he actually kind of clipped that very last hurdle at the end. I was a hurdler, but it was in seventh grade, so I don't really have much recollection of how much that slows you down or how much that affects you, but boy, it didn't seem to affect him, I don't guess, and just able to edge out his opponent. What a finish it was.
Well,
it fell down at the finish. Did you see that, Joey?
Yes, and you know what that actually what actually happened? He actually broke his arm as
wow.
he finished the race. And so what an incredible effort. Michael, I don't know. I can tell you I've never run so hard that I broke a limb. You know, I've never done that. So what an effort just to get it done. And for what Huslig has done at Oklahoma Christian, 5 times a Division II All-American. You throw in the All-American honors that he received with the NCCAA, the National Christian College Athletic Association. He's a 10-time All-American at Oklahoma Christian. What a fantastic career.
Well, and this is one of those additional stats that you kind of just throw in at the bottom of the article, which is pretty much what the Eagles staff did. But I want to mention this because his point total, Huslig's point total, was accumulated as for the team standings. Even though he was the only one there from Oklahoma Christian competing, he did earn 10 points. And, Joey, that was good enough for Oklahoma Christian to finish 25th place out of 112 teams. So Huslig on his own was a top 25 and number one at the same time.
It's very impressive. Very impressive. Congratulations to Landon Huslig and, of course, all those who have competed at the NCAA tournament, the national championship level. We'll have an opportunity to review some of these things over the course of the summer. Of course, I'll have an opportunity also to visit with Michael a little bit later on. But, Michael, as we wrap up today's edition of the GAC Weekly, You look back on the year as a whole, not so much the individual, and we'll talk about some of those throughout the course of the summer, because my goodness, football season, volleyball season, soccer season will be here before we know it. So we definitely want to talk about some of these fantastic moments that we've seen in the league this year, in year number seven. What do you look back on, though, on the whole, and as what you would say, this has been something for the GAC this year?
Well, you know, this year, and as you know, we do this on a part-time basis when we cover the championship events. We have other employment, and so that did keep me from seeing everything this year and being at all of the events. And so I do hate that I missed a few here and there this year, but it was another fantastic year for the GAC, and just so fortunate to be involved in it. I think if you go back to, you know, I don't want to leave anybody out necessarily here, but if you go back run.
We have time. We have time. Not necessarily on this episode, but we have time through
sure.
the summer. So we won't.
Well, I'll hit a few high points here then. I think if you go back to the season that Arkansas Tech had in volleyball, that was something that was fun to watch and really, honestly, quite remarkable, and something we haven't, you know, quite seen in the league in the past, I suppose. And of course, we've already talked about SAU softball and what they did, and the fact that the SAU baseball program was able to host the regional. And I know you talked about that a little bit last week, and just one win away from advancing to the College World Series on the baseball side as well. Those are just a few of the high points right off the top of my head, Joey, and I know there's so much more, but those are a few that come to mind. And then lastly is just the effort that so many people have to put forth to make these things happen. I mean, SAU also hosted the track and field championships this year for the Great American Conference, so don't forget that. And I think, yeah, they also hosted cross country. So you have those years where, you know, everything kind of turns up one school. It was Harding last year,
yes.
And I think really it's a lot could be put on Southern Arkansas this year for what they accomplished. And, you know, who knows who it'll be next year, maybe somebody else, and maybe one of those teams we've already seen a lot about. It is fun when you have that surprise team, and so I guess going into next year, I kind of look for wondering who that surprise team might be. Southern Nazarene football this year was a little bit of a surprise for some people, so that was fun to watch too.
And the men's basketball team with a lot of youth will definitely,
sure.
I would imagine, be back on the scene next year. So it could be a team from Bethany, Oklahoma. It could be any one of a number of schools that has the breakout year next year, but that's just a few months away. So, Michael, I appreciate that you've been on with me today here on the GAC Weekly. Thank you, and I look forward to getting to visit with you again a little bit later on as the weather hopefully doesn't get too much hotter.
Yeah, absolutely, Joey. And you're the hardest working broadcaster of the Great American Conference broadcasters. I'll tell you that. I love all your work. I'm honestly going to take a few days to do nothing here, but I'll be keeping up with everything that you're doing.
I'm trying to catch up. I'm just trying to catch up right now. But thank you. I appreciate that. My broadcast partner, Michael Westbrook, has been on the phone with me today as this edition of the GAC Weekly will wrap up. Now, please do, of course, follow along. We invite you to subscribe to the YouTube channel. It's Midwest Sports Net. That is the new home of the GAC Weekly, and our broadcasts have been live. So go ahead and watch the recap there, or actually watch a replay of this broadcast on YouTube. Go ahead and search out Midwest Sports Net, and please subscribe to our channel. Don't forget that Michael Westbrook will be back a little bit later on, and we're going to get to hear from some of these athletes who have had such a big impact on the 2017-2018 athletic year here in the Great American Conference. The GAC Weekly is brought to you by the Great American Conference. To hear more about this, the GAC, and other college and high school sports, please visit oklahomasports.net and arkansasports.net. I'm Joey McWilliams. Thanks a lot for watching. God bless you. Have a great day.